Hi, I'm Matt Dawes. I'm here today at Tunnelbound Farm. I'm going to run you through two methods of fishing for F1s that could put you more fish in the net this summer. Right, the way I like to start my matches, because shallow fishing takes a while to build your peg, you need to keep feeding it. I like to give it 30 minutes, an hour before I go on it. So the best way to start, I've found, is just start on the edge, find 2 foot, maybe a bit more, feeding ground bait with two maggots on the hook. Just simple, keep ticking over that first hour until that main line comes good. So basically, fishing in the margins couldn't be simpler. All you need, large cab pot, it's got the grooves on the bottom, make sure your bait comes out in the little column. And then I like to fish 11 olive for a short kit, down to 019 mainline. Then I've got a dead ship island floating to 414, just to get your bait straight to the bottom. You don't want to be messing around with little faffy rigs, just straight down where your bait's going to end up. The bulk mimics that, it's just a bulk of number 8s, 3-inch hook length and a size 16, so 013 power line. I like fishing at 013 because if you hook a carp, you don't want to be getting broke in these matches. You're looking like pounds, ounces that's going to cost you, so you need to get every fish in, and that gives you the best chance. That set up, it's perfect. Feeding the margins couldn't be simpler. I like to use my large pot, fill it with ground bait. This effectively is like fishing a method feeder. You're only going to get one or two fish in your peg at a time. You don't want to be putting loads of bait in, just one or two fish. Catch that fish, set your little trap, come again, and just repeat the process. That's the best way to do it down the edge. Shallow fishing is my main approach to catching big weights. There's either two scenarios you can do. When you're trying to catch 80, 90 pounds, you can fish it a bit further out because the fish feel more confident at 13, 14 metres when you're not looking for many bites. When you're trying to catch big, big weights, you want to be fishing 6 or 7 sections, catching your bait, throw it where you can throw it as well, and that's when you build your big weights. So right, where I've chose to fish my peg today, I've chose to fish 7 metres. This is because I've got the wind coming down, some scum in the edge, and I feel like the fishing is going to be good because the weather's been good this week. Looking where I can feed with my hand or my catapult, and this is where you're going to build a weight quickly. I'm going to run you through my rigs I've been using today. First one is set 10 inches deep, got 4 inches above the line, that's fishery rules. I use my little rule on my side tray just to make sure I'm in right every time. So basically I use 019 mainline, 0.1 dibber. I use just before the hook, 3 number 11 bulk, and I've got an 18 and a banded. I use the same line, same setup on all rigs, but the reason I've chosen a dibber for so shallow is it sits so much quicker. You won't believe how shallow these F1s can come. They can sit 6 inches deep, and if you have a bristle, you might take time just to go past that 6 inches, so they sit dead quick. I've got 4 rigs, all set just a little bit different depths of 4 inches. So that one's 10 inches. I've got a dibber again at 14, same, it's all the same. And then as I get lower down, I've got an F1 shallow, and if the fish are sitting deeper, you want to be able to read your float where they are and if you need to move your rig up and down a couple of inches. This brings me onto the last rig, and this is where you can really find the fish in your peg. It's a jigger. Everyone knows about these now. They're a brilliant way of catching F1s. Massive weights, but they're really effective if you use right. You can literally slide your stops. So I've got my bottom stop at 10 inches, and then say about 10 inches above that, I've got my other stop. So in between that, if I'm getting bites there, I can just quickly change my deeper rig or one of the dibbers to that depth, quick go. If I can't get a bite there, just if you're unsure where to fish, just have a little jigger set up. This is the best way to find out where the fish are. Sometimes they can drop 4 inches and you don't even realise, so that's my tip on that one. Right, my final point for shallow fishing F1s. I didn't believe about this at first with the grey kits, but after using these shallow, and I've used them in venues where it's very clear and you can see the fish, I believe it gives you that little edge. I like to conjunction this with a 9 holler. It's not it's not too light, but two strips of your pull are getting the fishes up in your net. And this is the best way of catching big weights. You're never going to get broke, you're never going to get fingered. It's just a brilliant elastic for that. So the two baits I've brought with me for the edge today are, I've got some ground bait, which is half match method mix original and half super crush. This lovely bait for the summer, nice and fluffy, it's got loads of pellets in it, fish love eating it. For the hook, I've just got simple, a few red maggots. I have put two or three on, depending on what's in my peg. If there's some carp in your peg, you can put three or four on. For some F1s, just two's good enough for them. Moving on to shallow fishing, I've got the ever faithful casters. Everyone knows how good these are for shallow fishing, but I like to use these because the more noise they create when they hit the water. In the high months of summer, you want fish responding to high noise. It's okay fishing maggots, but if you want that noise, then casters are the way. Try and get as fresh as you can so they're nice and crispy, hit the water and make a good sound. For a simple match, I look to bring 3 to 4 pints of casters. You don't need to feed many. I like to feed with a catapult. It slows me down with the feeding. Sometimes you hear people feeding by hand and they feed 6-7 pints. I don't believe that's necessary. Just simple 3 to 4 pints through a catapult is enough noise, enough bait to catch these F1s shallow. So basically, three types of bait when I'm fishing casters shallow. I've got the casters. I just leave these on my side rig, just a small pinch. This counteracts the hook, makes them more buoyant if you leave them on your side rig about water. Also, if you leave them on your side tree, a little bit tougher, so when you're slapping that rig, they're not going to burst, pop out your band, they're just going to stay there nice. Sometimes, as well, as a little trick of mine, is a black pellet. We all know dart. I like to use dart baits when I'm fishing shallow, and this is a little trick. It's more, sometimes in days when there's some silver fish in your peg, just slip a dart pellet on and you'll catch some extra F1s. Also, using your bandum, open it up, slide a little maggot in. It falls natural, so the fish think it's something a little bit different. So when shallow fishing, working hard is essential. I like to start at my shallowest point. Say that'd be 10 inches today. This is because if you drop down in the water, you're gonna find them at one point. If you start deeper, then you might have problems with fire lookers and you might not know where they are on your peg. So I always like to do that. Sometimes feeding can be different. Sometimes you have to feed one pouch, leave it, hang your bait there, then you'll get one. Other times you have to feed five constantly, keep slapping that rig on the water. And then if the venue allows, tapping the pole can be deadly. Simply just give it a shake with your knee, it'll tap the end of the water, and then literally, most of the time, the F1s just drag the pole out. This mimics your feed going in. So obviously they think your feed's coming in, but there's nothing there, your hook bait, F1 on. So that's my tips for that. There you go, another F1 on casters shallow. I hope you've enjoyed these tips and hope to see you on the bank soon.